So basically, this is a drill that I've been working on in order to deal with somebody who cuts freely from the bind. You tend to see this quite a bit, actually, both in the local scene and then also in a lot of videos that I've seen online. So essentially, what ends up happening is something like this. So if you want to do the cutting from the bind, right? So we'll end up in a bind like this, right? And then what happens is, so if Bernhard from here then just like cuts around to like some other target, right? So what we'll do is we'll just cut, right? So like this, and then basically that happens. So the question is, if all the German masters say you should fight from the bind, and they give us a lot of advice on how to fight from the bind and all this stuff, why, if it's so apparently easy to cut freely from the bind and win matches, basically, right? So what I realized is that we have some very, very good tools in order to deal with this, in order to punish somebody who does attempt to cut from the bind like that. So if we go from here, right? So we cut, right? So we'll just do this again, right? So we cut, right? Really all I'm doing is the equivalent of it's essentially doing an Abschneiden as a Nachreisen, right? So I'm following after his movement, right? And I'm doing a motion that you could either consider to be an Abschneiden, right? Because like in the scenario, we go like this, right? And if he decides to cut up, right? Then I go like this, right? But basically that's not, right, the Zwerchau gets us to here, right, which is what that Abschneiden is it's a Zwerchau done at close range with a slice to the wrist. But if we're at kind of the cutting range, so there's long range, and then there's thrusting range, and then there's cutting range, and then there's basically slicing range, and then there's like wrapping range. But really all it is I end up here, and I just do the first Binden or a Binden to an upper left hand, and as I go like this, as his sword slides down mine, right, it basically allows me to hit here. So there are other cuts that somebody can do from the bind, however, right? So if we go to here and we cut like this, and then he starts, so if he starts to cut over, and I think he's going to do that, right? I start to climb like this, right? But if he does something else, right? So say he's doing that and he's cutting, so say you cut it Zwerchau, right?
Okay.
Right? So we're cutting from the bind, right? And he starts to go like this, and I feel that he's left the bind, and I wind it back. Essentially the same way you do the second Binden, right? And from here I can do him with Tyrion, or my, you know, depending on how it goes, I can just cut straight down. Right, so if we do this a little bit more quickly, right, so, see, it looks kind of like that. Really all this is, so when we're in the bind, right, and if he does a thrust, look, I go like this, and he notices, right, the exact same way we have to use Frühling, right, so if I start to do this, it's like, oh crap, right, so what I'm going to do from here is I'm going to start to go to the second Binden, right, and maybe that works, or maybe not, right, maybe I start to do this, and he pushes further off my side, and now I have to turn it into a Zuken, right? Essentially, it's just using that first Binden movement, and a lot of times what a lot of people in this scenario actually want to do is they'll go like this, right? And instead of winding up like this, as someone cuts around, is they'll want to go like this, right? But a lot of times what happens is it goes like this, and then it just cuts down. So instead of winding to the completely opposite side, all you do is you do your initial cut, right? And as he cuts around, you wind up. And if we do this and I feel that he's managed to get to the other side of my sword, or I've essentially lost the bind, all I do is I would wind back down, and depending on how it is, I either go from up here down to this side. If he's cutting around to here, I'll usually get his blade here. Or if he's cutting around to the other side, or with his fair hell or whatever, I can get him here. But basically, I'm going like this, and I can cover this corner and this corner. Basically, as I'm moving, my sword will end up stopping just due to contact and all. So, like for instance, if you cut here and then you do it spare, on the same side, yeah.
Sure.
Right? So, kind of like this. See? So you start to go like this, but if you feel, right? So what happens is, right, we're in the body, and I start to feel a move back, and I go like this, and I feel that it's lost, right? And all I do, because it's not very far to go to, right? I'm going here, and I feel that this happens, and I just go back. And now I'm in a position to do a mutsira again. So that's the drill that we've been working on. And now I'm gonna get you guys to do this, and we'll get some footage of that. Awesome. Thanks.